Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to show you how to change your password in WordPress. Now, for many of you, maybe this is easy to do, but there are some people that are starting to use WordPress and they have no idea how to do it. So I want to show you exactly how to do that right now, because it's very important that you constantly change your password on a consistent basis, just because you want to protect your blog or your website. So let me show you how that's done. All right, so if you are already logged into WordPress, what you need to do is go over to the left side of the dashboard where you see this right here, scroll down, and you will see users. So go ahead and click on all users. All right, so when you come to all users, I have, of course, just one user, and you may have several, but I'm the only one, and I'm going to click on my username just to open up another page so that we can get to the password, and you should do the same thing as well. Now that we have clicked on this page, which is the profile page, we want to scroll down all the way down to the bottom of the profile page. Up a little too fast, but anyway, you are going to get to a section where it says account management, and this is where you want to be, because you will see new password here and it says set new password. So you can change this as often as you want, whenever you want. First thing that you need to do is go ahead and click on new password. Now, the minute you do it, you're going to generate some letters here, characters that WordPress already sets for you. So this is kind of like a password that they generated, and they do so because it has, you know, different letters, different characters, numbers, capital, lowercase, and this is what you want, which is a strong password. Now, you don't have to use this password. You can use a completely different password that you personalize. So if we erase that password, let's think of one. We can just use something very simple like "this is not my," and then use characters. So you can use something like that. And instead of using something obvious, let's try something with some numbers in it. Or better yet, let's just use this. So we'll use "this is not my password." And then you'll have those dollar signs. I'm going to go ahead and copy that, and then I'll hide it. And then what you need to do to save this is you need to scroll down to the bottom of the page, and you can save it down here where it says update profile. So when you go ahead and click on that, you're going to update your profile. So now that it is updated, it brings me back up to the very top. We want to make sure that this password works. So I'm going to log out so that we can log in and see how it works. Okay, so I have logged out where you see you are now logged out, and I'm going to log back in using that new password. Let's try that out right here. And I want you to see that I'm using the one that I typed in, which is right here. And then all I need to do now is add my username. All right, so now that we have the username and the password, we're going to go ahead and log in. And there it is. Voila. We are inside of the dashboard again. So that lets me know that, okay, everything is working. You can go ahead and copy, you know, your password down, put it in a safe place. But now let's say that you just want to try a different method. This is a method that a lot of people use on a ton of different sites. Usually on any login page, you're going to see this. So let's go back out again and let's log out so we can take a look at the second method. Okay, so now you see where it says you are logged out, because I just logged out again, of course. Now, the second method is usually on the main login page of any type of company that has a login page. It usually will say reset your password or lost your password. You'll see it down at the bottom, and you can also use this as well. Let's say that you lost your password. You can just go ahead and click on this, and it's going to bring you to this page. It says, please enter your username and email address. You will receive an email message with instructions on how to reset your password. But what you need is one of two things. You have to know your username or your email address in order to do this. We are going to go ahead and add our username, or better yet, I'll do the email address. And we're going to go ahead and get a new password. Now it says check your email for the confirmation link, then visit the login page. Let's head over to my email. So here we are inside my email, and here's the first email. The other one changed. This is the reset. And now that I'm in here, it says that you requested to change your password. It has a link for me to click on. I'm going to go ahead and click on that link so that I can take me to the next page. Okay, so the link that I clicked on took me to this page, and it says enter your new password below or generate a new one. So I am not going to use the password that they gave me. We're going to generate a new one. So if you want one that's personalized, then you can do that. So I'm going to try something a little bit different. And because I know that WordPress likes it to be all complicated and things like that, they want you to keep it very difficult for people to try to get into your website and things like that. I am going to try and make this as complicated as possible. So we will try something like, we're just going to use characters like try a harder, we'll try ER, passcode. And when we use maybe A, maybe we'll use this, maybe we'll use a different type of, you know, character. So we will use code. And we will do another hashtag. So this is, I think, is quite difficult. So you've got to be able to put this in a place where you can remember, or, you know, some place where you won't lose it. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to copy this so that you see exactly what it is. Now I'm going to close it out and I am going to save the password. It took it. There's times before where I have did that and it will literally make me do a new password because it's not strong enough. So it says your password has been reset. So now we're going to go ahead and log in. So now we're going to try that password and I'm going to show you what I just used. This is it. This is what I just had, right? So that you see that I actually changed it. Then we're going to try my username. Now that we have that, we're going to get logged in. So here we are back at the dashboard. So that method worked as well. So those are two very simple methods. Most people tend to use one or the other, whatever it is that you want to use. I find them to be extremely simple, a way to reset your password. Okay, so there's another way for you to change your password, but I don't find this step to be very necessary. So what you can do is you can go up to the top of the page where your URL is. You want to backspace all the way up to the forward slash, and it's here where you are going to type in cpanel. Now this cpanel, it's not a bad way to change your password. However, you know, it's not that hard, but it's not a 1-2-3 step type of thing. You know, I think the first two methods are more common and more easy to do. But if you want to go through the cPanel, this is how you can do it. If you click on cPanel right here, and this is what you'll have, this page that comes up. Now, once you go ahead and put your, you know, username, same thing, password in, you can go through several more steps that can allow you to change, you know, your password and possibly and even your username. But I don't typically use this, honestly. I just use the first two methods. You will see that other people actually will teach using this method, but I don't think it's really necessary. If I were you, I would just stick with either changing your password through the user, this user section, or you can use the homepage of WordPress and just basically say that you can't remember your password or you lost it. That's probably the easiest route to go. All right, so let me know down in the comment section below if you are using one of these three methods. Maybe you are using the cPanel method, or maybe you are using this method right here within the dashboard section. Let me know down in the comment section below which one you find to be the easiest. All right, guys, so if you like this video, then go ahead and give me a thumbs up. And also make sure that you check out my other video, how to add a table of content to a blog post. All right, guys, thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you on the next one.